When the sun comes out, so do the street traders, and whatever they sell, they draw big crowds.
Pay me a tenner to clear them out of the way.
It's caused great concern to Westminster City Council, who believe that the public are being ripped off by many of the hawkers. So much so that not only are they having the courts issue injunctions to stop certain traders from using their streets as a shop front, they're also holding back the licenses they now need to work. One trader who's fallen prey to the tough regime is Billy Scott. This morning, the High Court told him that he would no longer be able to work on the streets of Westminster.
I've worked in the street now for going on 5 years. It's been my limit for 5 years. I've gone into the High Court this morning for the fourth time. And the three previous times I've been in the High Court, I've beaten the council, I've won. And I've gone in there this morning and within 5 minutes, without even having a chance of having a say for myself, they've taken my liberty away from me, straight, just like that.
What effect is it going to have on you?
Well, it's going to have a tremendous effect because, like I say, for the last 5 years now, I've worked in the street. It's been my living. Yeah. I have a mortgage, all the financial commitments that come with it. And it's a complete blow for me.
For people like Billy, who says he's doing no wrong, it means a complete change of
lifestyle.
But Billy isn't alone.
Within the last 2 years, the council have now, to my knowledge, brought out 15 injunctions against street workers in this street. And it's more or less wiping out all street traders in Oxford Street.
But in spite of that, Billy Scott is yet another character that has disappeared from London's streets. And with fewer licences being issued, it's unlikely he'll reappear. Lisa Davidson in Oxford Street for Thames News.
These are today's GVs of Oxford Street. So don't let them be used next week.